First up on today's show, we've got Mahid Khan with the story on the House GOP trying to impeach the Mayorkas after failing.
Then we have Maya Zarif with the story on the Wicked trailer.
Lastly, we have a brand new installment of Local Government.
All of that and much more on today's episode of Flyer News.
Roll that intro. Good morning, Flyers. Today is day six with periods running D-A-B-E-G. From Flyer News, I'm Mikey Anastasi.
And I'm Mary Carney.
Hey, Mary, did you hear about the Homeland Security wanting to impeach someone?
No, I didn't. Who are they impeaching? What for? I have so many questions.
Welp, I can answer a few of them. I wish I could help, but I don't know all of the answers, because I don't know much.
I'm listening.
But, okay, so I can help. So, with more on it, let's send it over to Mahid Khan, because I don't know anything.
House Republicans are gearing up for another attempt to impeach Homeland Security Secretary Alejandro Mayorkas, focusing on the Biden administration's handling of the migrant crisis along the U.S.-Mexico border. The vote was scheduled for yesterday evening, and it was expected to be close, which it was. Speaker Mike Johnson's GOP majority couldn't afford many defections or absences, especially with Democrats firmly against impeaching Mayorkas. This second go-around highlights the GOP's determination to address their priorities. Mayorkas faces two charges: intentionally neglecting to enforce existing immigration laws and misleading Congress about border security. This shift in focus came after Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene pushed for Mayorkas' impeachment, redirecting attention from an inquiry into President Biden's son's business dealings. Despite initial momentum, the impeachment effort hit a snag when three Republican representatives opposed it, questioning its validity and usefulness. Success in impeaching Mayorkas depends on a narrow majority, making every single vote crucial. If the House moves forward with impeachment, which it didn't, the matter goes to the Senate for trial. However, bipartisan reluctance in Senate suggests the possibility of shelving the issue indefinitely, underscoring the political divide on border security. Border security has become a top campaign issue, with former President Donald Trump advocating for aggressive deportation measures. Meanwhile, legislative efforts to address migration policies face challenges due to partisan gridlock. In addition to Mayorkas, House Republicans have targeted several Biden administration officials for impeachment, highlighting the political discord. Successfully impeaching Mayorkas would mark a historic precedent, reflecting the current contentious political climate. Mayorkas has attributed the border crisis to congressional inaction on immigration reform, emphasizing the need for legislative intervention. Republicans, on the other hand, have advocated for executive actions similar to those taken during the Trump administration, despite legal constraints. My name is Mahid Khan, and let's take it back to the desk.
So, don't you find it how odd people outside of Massachusetts don't say wicked? I mean, bubbler and so many other things?
It's so weird. Like, it's second nature to us, but other people look at us and think that we had two heads.
Well, speaking of the word wicked, I think there's a new movie trailer about Wicked.
Yes, there is. I saw it on an ad for the Super Bowl.
Oh, I would love to watch that.
Well, thankfully, we have Maya to share a trailer now.
This past Sunday, the trailer for the new movie adaptation of Wicked dropped during the Super Bowl. Fans are getting even more excited for the first part of the two-part film series. With Ariana Grande starring as Glinda and Cynthia Erivo as Elphaba, we know we have casting in the right hands. Grande has dreamed of playing the role of Glinda since she was merely 10 years old, and now her dream has come true. Ariana Grande said in an interview in May of 2022 that she is going to have every piece of her, every minute, every ounce of her heart, her time, and her soul into her favorite role. From the looks of this trailer, we can see that she has truly given it her all. Erivo, playing Elphaba, explains that the story is split into two movies because the producers have expanded on the girls' relationship as friends. Waiting a whole year for the second part to come out will be a challenge, but for huge fans, it is worth it. Production had officially wrapped up this past January, and the first film is set to release on November 27th, 2024, just in time for a wonderful holiday season. The second part will be released a year later. The Broadway musical of Wicked premiered in 2003 and since then has become a major hit. The musical has made over $5 billion in global sales and has won numerous awards. On April 11th, 2023, with its 7,486th performance, it officially became Broadway's longest-running musical. Now that the show is being made into a movie, more people can enjoy it and get transported into Oz. I have a feeling this film will be wicked good. I'm Maya Zarif, and let's take it back to the desk.
To be bored during school vacation next week, because there are plenty of activities in Massachusetts to try for kids and adults alike. On the North Shore, visit the Peabody Essex Museum in Salem and explore the environment with its latest exhibit. On the South Shore, check out what's on display in the Pilgrim Hall Museum in Plymouth. If nature is your thing, you can visit a zoo or take a walk at one of the state's many nature reserves. Or maybe you feel like touring the old North Church in Boston, building the USS Constitution. The USS Constitution using Legos, or attending a Bugs Bunny's cartoon festival. The possibilities are many. Have fun and enjoy your February breaks.
School suspensions had doubled in this last year to last year. Framingham High School reported that they had more cases than ever, where students were reported biting, fighting, kicking, punching, and swearing at staff. During the previous city council meetings, Robert Tremley spoke out about the violence and frustration that comes along with it. His first idea was to divide different aspects of the student body. The district is also exploring alternative programs that can happen after school hours. Tremley said, quote, "We have a very large building that is basically empty after 3 p.m., end quote. City Council and the school board are working very hard in order to hopefully find a solution to these actions." Hmm. I wish I was still in elementary school.
I don't, but why do you wish to return?
I mean, it was awesome. We got nap time and ice cream. How much better could it get?
Okay, I can't blame you on that statement. Where'd you go to elementary school? I went to Hemingway.
I went to Hemingway as well.
What? No way! Also, I heard that they were moving the school to a different location. Yeah. With more on this topic, let's send it over to another Hemingway veteran, Achilles Hicks.
Good morning, Flyers. Welcome to another installment of Framingham Local News. I'm your host, Achilles Hicks, and today we're going to be talking about the authorization to build a new building for Hemingway Elementary School. Mayor Sizitsky named the city councilor, George King Jr., to lead the project of replacing Hemingway Elementary with the new building on the south side of Framingham. King, who had previously served as the assistant superintendent of the Nashoba Regional School District, will be the chair of the 13-person school building committee. He was one of the already three named members of the city council to serve, alongside District 5 Councilor Noble Alexander and District 9 Councilor Tracy Bryant. District 4 committee member Adam Frudberg was also named by Sizitsky to be the vice chair. To round out the committee are Matteo Batista, Rosalind Child, Rachel Evans, David Pinich, Jessica Barnhill, David Gordon, Aaron Asbury, Brittany Capiers, and Scott Wadland. The appointments come after the Massachusetts School Building Authority invited Framingham Public Schools to explore funding a new school building. King's background in finance has given him a keen eye for detail and an ability to navigate complex budgets, while his experience in education has given him a deep understanding of the needs of students, teachers, and administrators, the mayor said in a statement. When he served in Nashoba, he was part of the construction of the Center Elementary School in Stowe, Massachusetts. During that time, he said he gained a lot of experience that's going to help him with the new school in Framingham. Freudberg will also serve as a useful member, being a member of the committee to build Fuller Middle School a couple years ago. Although King himself isn't fully knowledgeable of the state of Hemingway Elementary School, he knows that it's a much older building that isn't sufficient for the current enrollment and curriculum. Because the Hemingway School is on a relatively small plot of land, building a modern school with preschool for four-year-olds at that same spot was determined to be impossible. That meant a different location was needed. creating an opportunity for move to the South Side, said the Metro West Daily News. We look forward to serving on this important project, King said in a statement. As someone who went to elementary school practically next door from where we hope to build a new school, I appreciate the importance of establishing a new school in such a large population in the center of the city. For me, I wonder what would become of the old elementary school and what it's going to be in its place when the new building is open. Well, that's all for today's episode of Framingham Local News. I'm Achilles Hicks, and let's take it back to the desk.
That's all the time we've got for today's episode of Flyer News.
You can rewatch this and other broadcasts again on our YouTube channel or on the FEC tab on the school's website.
Also, while you're at it, don't forget to follow us and check us out on Instagram and Facebook at Framingham High Studios.
But don't go anywhere just yet, because we have the latest installment of The Early Bird. From Flyer News, I'm Mary Carney.
And I'm Mikey Anastasi. Happy Friday, FHS!
Happy Friday, day before break. Break is right around the corner. I wanted to say thanks for holding it down yesterday without me.
So you were in China?
I was in China. I took a high speed jet.
Ah, okay.
Traveled at the speed of light. And
yeah. How much jet fuel did I use?
A lot. Just don't tell the economy.
Oh, yeah.
How much we polluted and how much money.
You mean
we
the environment? Definitely.
Yeah,
definitely.
All that. Yeah.
All right. Well, that's all right. But it was you had a good time in China today?
Yeah, very fun. I'll tell you more about it later.
Okay. Yeah, now's not the time. We don't have a lot of time today. You know,
We got to get running.
Yeah, get it running. So without further ado, let's roll the intro.
Good morning, Flyers, and welcome back to The Early Bird. I'm Zach Schneider, and with me, as always, is Ben DeGroat.
Zach, it's Friday. It's the day before break. It doesn't even feel like the day before break.
No, I think it's because we're all, honestly so drained that we just need this day.
We just need it. We just need it to be break, and I'm very happy for a week. All right. But Zach, today we've got some celebrity. We did this before.
We're doing an encore.
All right, but
it was very popular.
Zach, I have a challenge for you today. I have a prize.
Yep.
All right, I'm not going to show you what the prize is, but if you can get more than three right, if you can get four right,
four,
If you can get four of these celebrities, guess their names, even just their first name.
Yep.
I will give you a prize, okay?
All right.
Actually, if it's three, maybe I'll consider as well. All right, let's just get right to it.
Let's get this bad John running.
Oh, I know exactly who that is.
Yo, what? This is celebrity or actor?
It's a celebrity. Yeah, no, it's definitely a celebrity.
How do you know?
I'll give you a hint. She has her own show.
Oh, is it Jennifer Hudson?
No, it's not she Jennifer has Hudson.
Jennifer Hudson show.
Zach, it is she Oprah has... Winfrey.
Okay, whatever.
It
next.
Is Oprah Winfrey. I don't know. All right. It's okay. It's okay.
I can't tell Oprah from the Winfrey eye.
I can clearly tell from the eye because it's obviously Oprah Winfrey. Let's go to the next
I
one.
Feel like you
let's go to the next
put
one.
These in.
I didn't put the. Oh, I know. Come on.
Put what?
Rush Hour. You seen Rush Hour?
No, I haven't.
What else is he in? I don't know what else he is in. He does a lot. He does his own stunts, Zach. He does his own stunts. He's an actor.
Harry Houdini's dead.
It's definitely not Harry Houdini. Zach, you can't tell like anything about this guy.
I can tell he might be old. I see a lot of wrinkles.
There. Well, now he is old. He does kung fu stuff in his movies and stuff. Zach, come on.
I don't watch movies.
If I get, like, give the whole picture, let's see if Zach can get it.
I probably can't.
Do you have any idea?
No.
It's Jackie Chan, Zach. You never heard of Jackie Chan?
I don't know celebrities.
Okay. You're 0 for 2. I'm saying if you get three.
So I just have to get three. All right.
If you get three,
I'm not going to get three.
Out of four, I guess, then you will get the prize. All okay?
Right. Yep.
But let's see the next one. We'll see the next one.
Queen Elizabeth?
That is Queen Elizabeth. Wow, good job, Zach. Incredible. You're 1 for 3.
She looks really happy.
You're doing, yeah. She looks so happy to be alive. But anyways, though, this one's actually pretty hard. It took me.
How do you know all of these? Did you see all of these?
No, wait. Actually, I'm not 100% sure anymore if I know who that is.
Give me the full picture.
Okay. You don't know who that is?
Is it like a squished
Wait,
image?
It is kind of squished. It's pretty hard to tell because it is kind of squished. But I'm pretty sure Zach, she's in like the Capital One
It's
commercial?
Jennifer Garner.
Jennifer Garner. Okay, yeah. Wow, Zach. Okay,
so
good
that's
job.
That's two.
2 for 4. All right, so we have 2 more questions.
I was going to say, that does not look like her. She's like squished.
Well, yeah, it's kind of a weird image. It's Jennifer Garner, though.
Yeah.
But we 2 more questions. If you get 1 for 2, you get the prize. You get the prize, Zach. Good work. Before we get to those questions, though, we have the pledge.
Life is older than the trees, younger than growing like a breeze, country roads, take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Which means this is like end of the like 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter right now.
Bottom of the ninth.
You just got a bottom of the ninth. Yep. What else? End of the third period. And is that even?
All right.
I don't
who is it? I
this is the next
know.
One. Oh,
you know who it is.
I do know who it is. There's a new movie that came out with
him. I
was
supposed to tell from the eye and the little bit of hair.
Okay, well,
give me the whole picture.
The thing is, I can tell.
Yeah,
so.
But you actually know
okay.
stuff.
Yeah,
the whole
okay,
picture.
Okay. Whole picture. Do you know who that is?
No.
You don't know who that
no.
is?
So I'm gonna rely on the last
Oppenheimer?
One. No.
You seen? Nope. You don't even
I feel
know.
Like I have, but I don't still remember.
It's Cillian Murphy. Cillian Murphy. No. Cillian Murphy. That's Cillian Murphy. He's in Oppenheimer. He's a pretty famous actor.
Yep.
All right, but last one. This is your last chance, Zach. Oh, this one's so easy.
I don't know from her forehead.
Okay, it's not even a celebrity. It's not a celebrity. This is like someone you should be able Honestly, Zach, you shouldn't have to
Is it someone in the government?
Yes.
It's Kamala Harris.
Congratulations, Zach. You won, which means you win a prize. I'm not going to reveal the prize, though, until after the announcements.
Hi, everyone. The
The class of 2026 is having a school Olympics, which is a field day type event. We're going to have multiple events like tug of war, limbo, and cornhole. The cost is $5 per person, and there are 6 people per team. You can sign up through the link in our bio at Class of 2026 Officers or by the posters hung up around the school in our QR codes. Thank you. Hope to see you there.
Congratulations on your win.
It's a good way to end the school week.
And your prize is a LeBron James, a gibbet of LeBron James face.
Oh.
Zach, you want to?
Just what I want.
Yeah.
Just what I want.
Just for your Crocs.
A gibbet
you
of
You want to show it to the camera? Show
gibbet
it to the camera.
It's very the cry, small. Baby.
It's a gibbet of LeBron James.
Yep.
In his face. And it's pretty well made. You know,
yeah.
I don't know if.
I remember when this was gifted to you.
Yeah, it was a long time ago.
Thanks for passing it back.
Yeah, it was just I thought it was special.
And very special.
It's the face of a celebrity, if you think about it.
Oh, celebrity.
So, you know, it kind of
I'll never forget him.
All right, well, Zach, that's all the time we have for. We got to get to class.
Get these. D period.
These last five classes done before we get to February break.
Yeah.
So, without any more.
Interruptions.
We'll close this show out because the early bird gets the worm.